Howard Stern Show.
Whenever I'm covered up is when I'm depressed.
Yes.
You know, if I don't have a wig on or if I don't have makeup on, if I'm not dressed up, my family's like, are you okay? You know, because it's this always been the way that I've expressed myself. And
You're a very emotional person. There's a story that when you were recording with Tony, I'm trying to think what song you were doing. You were doing Lush Life, I think.
Yes.
That you broke down in tears. And you were like almost crumpled up on the floor. And Tony swept you up. He held you. He hugged you. And he said, you said to him, do you think I'm a nut or do you think I'm a maniac?
I said, I'm so sorry. I hope I'm not a mess. I said, I don't want to be a mess for you.
And he turned to you and said what?
He said, you're not a mess. Don't worry. You're just a sophisticated lady.
He knows what to say to you.
He does.
But why were you so affected by this song, Lush Life? What was going on?
Well, this song was given to me. I've got to shout him out. So wonderful. My jazz teacher when I was, I don't know, 13 years old, Mr. Phillips, he gave me this song when I was just a baby. And he said, you got to sing this song. And it was Billy Strayhorn. And, you know, I said, I don't know, what does Lush Life even mean? I didn't even understand the lyrics. And the ominous tone, this heavy, dark song, it was so strange. But, you know, I like strange things, so I really liked the song. He said, you can sing this. So I sang it when I was 13. When Tony said he wanted me to sing it, and I was still going, oh, God, I haven't sang that song in almost 15 years. And I sat down to sing it, and the many mornings of alcohol and drugs just began to flash through my eyes, and the sadness and the deep sort of just empty void that I was always trying to fill with something, you know, smoke it, pop it, you know, suck it, whatever it was going to do. And it was like to sing with such a gentleman that wanted nothing from me but my friendship. That's why I'm so fiercely passionate about defending our relationship, is because, you know, of all the men, Howard, that I've worked with, he's never done nothing in the studio. And he never, you know, it's like not even in the car.
No weird vibe.
Nothing. It's so crazy to even think about. And you know,
are
the
number. Are you
saying
that every man, not every man, but most men that you work with do something inappropriate with
yes,
you? They do.
With the exception, Red One was the first one who did it.
Wow.
You know, and that's why, you know, that album was successful. It's because I was able to write some music that, you know, wasn't made while I had the fear of God in me pulling my skirt down in a studio because, you know, men were shoving their hands at my dress.
Are you serious? Like it's that bad out there? I mean, I know it's, I know men are perverted, but
not only is it bad, but it's still bad now.
It's still going on, even at your level of fame.
Well, for not just for me, but for think about all those young girls that are 16 in New York and 19 going, I met this record producer, quote unquote, he's going to make me a star. He said he worked with, you know, Beyonce or whoever. And then, you know, they didn't really work with Beyonce and they didn't really work with this person. And it's all a big lie.
Why not call them all out? Why not name names and say, this is a guy, this is a bad guy, that's a bad guy? Why do we let these guys get away with it?
You know,
why do we?
I don't really. I mean, I've talked a lot about it, and if you do the math and you look in the history of who I've worked with, it doesn't take a lot of rocket science to figure it out. But
Why do we?
I think that the music industry puts too much into the hands of record producers right now, and not enough into the hands of the artists. And I think that once record executives start to support female artists more and sign girls that have studied music, don't sign girls with big boobs who've had plastic surgery, who don't know how to sing, that you think you know they're a model and you can train them into superstardom. You know, that is just not how it's done. And and working with Tony and go, I'm watching this guy nail it.
Do you think Tony is such a great guy, or do you think it's because he's 88 and he's lost that kind of like perversion guys have? And like, you know, maybe when he was 20, he would have hit on you.
No.
But Tony is a special guy.
Listen,
you don't know.
Listen, I wish I could go back in time. You know,
right.
I wish I could go back in time for a lot of reasons. You know, sometimes I feel like I wasn't meant for this time in music.
You would have probably done better, you think, maybe 40 years ago.
I think in the 70s,
right. Oh, in the 70s. Yeah, well, that's probably true, I would think.